Good evening. My name is Paula Cochran, and I'm the director of orchestras in Ponca City. And I'd like to introduce to you our staff for this evening. We have with us this evening Mr. Andrew Orr. He is director of percussion and is our symphonic director with all of our band students on the stage this evening. We have Ms. Katie Roth, assistant orchestra director. We joining me tonight on the podium will be Mr. Hinch, assistant orchestra director. And we also have our concert hall coordinator, Ms. Penny Maples. She is the reason that everything is functioning this evening. And last but not least, our retired maestro, Mr. Dan Larson. And now we present to you our 2019 Pohai Symphonic Orchestra.
Thank you. Thank you.
In order for an orchestra to be a sweepstakes accent award winner, it requires achieving at the highest level at four different particular aspects of the contest. The first contest happens in the fall, and the string group that's in front of you has to go to a state contest, and they have to receive superior ratings on stage, which they did. And then in the spring, what did I say the spring twice? In November and the fall, they have the string contest where they get their superior ratings. And then in February, we have to take the full orchestra. And that's where it gets tricky because you're adding 25 band students to the string program who do not rehearse with us daily. These students attend evening rehearsals, they attend 7 a.m. morning sectionals, and then they have to go to contest with us and perform on stage and receive superior ratings, which they did. And then the string group has to go into the sight reading room and perform a piece of music they've never seen before after an 8-minute study period. And this group in front of you, yes, they did. And then the fourth part, so you get your sweepstakes award by doing that. And then the string groups had to take large ensembles to a solo and ensemble contest. First a district contest at NOC where they have to pass on to state, and then they go to state at OSU, and you have to get a certain number of ensembles through in order to achieve your accent award, which this group in front of you did. So if we could have a hand of applause for these students. They do everything I ask of them, sometimes not with a smile on their faces, but they do everything that I ask of them, and we appreciate the traditions being continued. So at this time, we would like to award our symphony band members with their letters, for if they were not a part of our program, we would not be a sweepstakes accent award-winning orchestra. So if my band students could go towards Mr. Orr when your name is called and get your letter or your bar, and then please line up for a picture, and hopefully my photographer is back there ready to take a photo. Our first student, I'm going to read them and you can just walk, is Brittany Adair, flute, Adriana Anson, clarinet, Eileen Colley, piano and percussion, Jocelyn Davis, flute, Christina Hines, clarinet, Nicholas Hoker, trumpet, Skylar Jernigan, flute, Hayden Jones, tuba, Drew Markle, French horn, Andrew Rogers, percussion, and Connor Shear, trombone. These are first-year award-winning letter orchestra awards. Thank you so much. Second year. Marley Brophy, trumpet, Feather Campbell, flute, Jocelyn Durgati, clarinet, Evan Smith, percussion, Ryan Turnipseed, trumpet. Second-year letter orchestra award winners. When I was putting together all my rubrics, I wondered why we didn't have any three-year letter award recipients, and I realized, well, if you see the group that got four-year, there wasn't room the following year for freshmen to join us, because the following students are four-year orchestra award-winning students: Joshua Branch, clarinet, William Corr, French horn, Michael Hooper, trombone, Landon Linder, percussion, Robyn Maloney, bassoon, Louis Ramirez, clarinet, and Logan Stout, trombone. Mr. Orr, if you could sneak into this picture, and if my string players could smile so the background is beautiful, let's take a picture, please. My photographer's right in the back. This is your symphonic band that is a member of our orchestra. Thank you very much, Duke. We'll give them a moment to be seated, and then we'll present to you Phantom of the Opera. are seniors. Miss Jessie Anderson is with her mother, Lori Anderson. Jessie will be attending NOC and focusing on business management. She then plans on going to OSU for culinary arts and business management. Her goal is to open her own coffee shop here in Ponca City so that her color guard and orchestra friends will have a place to visit. Her favorite memory of being an orchestra member was beating Doug at Six Flags and seeing Mrs. Cochran with her stuffed Pokemon for her son, Jesse Anderson. We have Adriana Anson. She is escorted by her parents, Christy and Randy Anson. She's planning on attending NOC to get her basics in early elementary education, then transferring to OSU to complete her degree. Her favorite memory is learning fun and challenging music with her friends. Alex Bird is escorted by his mother, Tressa Berg, and father Kip Berg with stepmother Kelly Berg. Alex has not decided on his career path, but plans to attend NOC and see where the world will take him. His favorite memory is the Dallas trip and eating at the Italian restaurant when Bailey Huggins, she ate the really hot pepper not knowing how spicy it was, and needless to say, she had to order a glass of milk. Alex Berg. Has his mother, Kelly Branch Foster, and his stepfather, Jim Foster, with him tonight. Joshua is off to Southwestern Oklahoma State University to pursue a degree in music education and someday conduct a full high school orchestra. His best memory was on February 13th, coming back from state contest and spending valuable time with his best friend, a time he will remember and cherish forever. Gorgeous mom, Brandy Cain, and her really cool dad, Joey Cain, with her this evening. Kate is headed to Oklahoma Baptist University to pursue a degree in sports medicine and teaching, and wants to further her education into a physician's assistant program. Kate's memory is the trip to Dallas and meeting Macy, her best friend, and she cannot imagine her life without her. Feather Campbell is escorted by her father, Sky Campbell, and sister, Raina Campbell. Feather will be attending NOC and then on to OSU for a degree in music. Feather has always enjoyed the bus rides, state contest, and then off to the mall. William Cork is with his mother, Laura, and his father, William. He's off to college to study music and hopes to write his own music and have his own jazz band. His favorite memory is working with Mr. Larson. Mike and Katrina Crossland have the pleasure of escorting two of our seniors, Jeffrey Crossland and Jason Marcusoni. Jeffrey, their son, is off to Oklahoma Baptist University to study biology. Jason Marcusoni will be entering the Army to serve his country and will be leaving shortly for his basic training. These guys' best memory was making new friends, Andrew, Jaden, and Tyler. Douglas Foster
is escorted by his mother, Tammy Foster, and dad, Douglas Foster Jr., and a little one, and plans to have some take some college classes at the University Center, and will work his way up to OSU. His best memory is traveling to Branson and playing with the Texas Tenors. Jamie Gill has her parents, Amanda and Sean Gill, and plans to attend NOC pursuing music and hopes to produce and make her own music. Her best memory was the Halloween concert when she was a sophomore and Mr. Larson wore the penguin suit. Annie Graham is escorted by her father, Cardinal Graham. She will be attending Northern Oklahoma College and then off to Oklahoma City to be a sonogram technician. Her favorite memory was going to state contests and bringing home those ones. Has with him his mother, Kelly Adams. Michael plans to attend NOC to further his education, but is undecided in the major at this time. His best memory is just making good music with the orchestra. Madison Hurley has with her mother, Jennifer Hurley. Madison plans to attend NOC and then off to OU to pursue a career to become an oral surgeon. Her favorite time as a sophomore was traveling to Branson with the orchestra. Jody Leonard and his sister Landry. Landon will be attending NOC and become a member of the NOC Jazz and Concert Band. His memories include hanging out with his friends and just playing good music. Robyn Maloney is escorted by her loving parents, Rex and Anna Maloney, as well as her younger brother, Aaron. She is planning on attending OSU to achieve a bachelor's degree in music, major in animal science, and a doctorate in veterinary medicine. She wants to move back to Ponca City and work towards opening her own veterinary clinic, helping music students in Ponca City. Her favorite memory was playing under Mr. Larson and experiencing Mrs. Cochran's first year of being lead director. And she says that Mrs. Cochran did a lot better than she gives herself credit for. Christina Olderwald is escorted by her mother, Christina Olderwald, and father, Alex Estes. She plans to attend NOC and study business, and hopefully open her own bakery. Her best memories are going to Dallas. It was her first school big trip, and it was so much fun and very interesting. By her mother, Tanya, and grandmother, Lucy Jackson. She plans to attend NOC in the fall and further her education in family counseling. Her favorite night was playing on the 2018 concerto and ending an era with Mr. Larson. Johnson Shuley is with his parents, John and Sarah Shuley. Dawson will be off to NSC to study psychology, and his favorite memory is the Branson trip. Logan Stout has with him his mother, Leona Stout. Logan plans to attend OSU in the fall and get a technology degree. His best memories are seen during Pirates of the Caribbean. Laura Sutherland is escorted by her father, Yoray A. Sutherland, her mother, Brandy Maupin, and great-grandmother, Liz Maupin. She plans to attend NOC and study mechanical engineering. Her memory was the Dallas trip. Emma Bailey and I made Cassidy Broom ride on the kitty train, and it made her cry. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to present to you our 2018-2019 seniors.
Thank you.
We have waited such a long time for this moment. Every time we end a concerto concert, the alumni wants to come back and play Hymnsong with Mr. Larson, and the Howe Auditorium is so small. You know, I think I made 600 programs and we ran out, but in a hall that seats 1,204 people, it still looks like it's empty, and it's not. There's more than 600 of you here this evening. So we're inviting 35 plus alumni to the stage at this time to join Mr. Larson in playing our finale Hymnsong. And what's important about this moment is that these students and these alumni and their parents are part of the reason that bond issue passed. And they never got to play in the hall. Tonight was some of the first moments they had just walking through the door. So I'm gonna hand the phone over to Mr. Larson.
Space in the program for this final piece doesn't begin to give it justice. So while our alumni are coming on, I was asked to talk about my Hymnsong of Philip Bliss. It was originally written by a man by the name of Horatio Spafford back in the late 1800s. He had a family of one boy and four daughters. Well, he lost the boy to a disease, and then in 1871, the Great Fire of Chicago wiped out his business, and basically he was kind of starting over again. But within 2 years, he had rebuilt that business and finally were able to take a vacation. So he and his wife decided to go to a cruise to England, where there was also a couple of his favorite evangelists who were speaking over there, so he could see them, hear them, and at the same time get a vacation. Well, at the last minute, he had a business obligation he had to meet, but he decided to send his wife and daughters on, and he would rejoin them in a day or two. While that ship was in the middle of the ocean, it was hit by a freighter, and it sank, and his four daughters were wiped out. And his wife was found clinging to wreckage. She made it to London, sent a message back to her husband, talking about the loss of their four daughters. Well, then he then got on a ship to go across to join his wife. And over the very spot that the ship had sank, he wrote the hymn, "It Is Well With My Soul." Well, along came Philip Bliss, who found the words and asked him if he could write the music to it. And one of the sad parts of that is they think it may be one of the last hymns, if not the last hymn, that he ever wrote, although most of the time he wrote his own words and music. But on this one, he was so taken by the words of Horatio Spafford's song that he asked if he could do the music to it. Anyway, right after that happened, he and his wife were killed in a train accident, derailment, I believe, in Ohio. So the piece has some history behind it. What you're hearing tonight is taking the music from the hymn by Philip Bliss, and David Holsinger came along and wrote it for concert band first. And then enough orchestra directors gave David Holsinger a hard time that he wrote it for orchestra. That kind of gives you a little bit of the history of the hymn. The second part of this is, back several years ago, it's on the required list for contests to choose from. The group had played that, don't tell them how many times that year, and they got to the last concert, I left it off the program. But we have enough music to perform. Back in the day, we were doing 8, 9, 10 concertos, and I said, we've got enough music. And they said, well, this is important to us. We had just discussed the hymn and the meaning behind it, and that group of seniors had lost a lot of relatives, friends, that particular year. It was an important piece to them. Because the hymn didn't just talk about loss, the piece talked about renewal and feeling good. No matter what my lot in life has taught me to say, it is well with my soul. And that was important to that group. So I said, well, let's just see how things go, and if we get to the end of the concert and you still want to do it, well, we'll do it. We got to the end of the concert, and they were pretty tired, and I said, do you still want to do this piece? And they said, yes, it's important to us. So we did it. And that's kind of become the tradition of Ponca City Orchestras for the very last piece on their final concert of the year. The seniors every year since that point in time have said, we want to do a Hymnsong of Philip Bliss. So the next time you happen to sing this in church, in the words of, when peace like a river or when Sorrel's like, see Bill of the Roll, get a little, maybe a better understanding of what was going on in Horatio Spafford's life, that's what he wrote. And the great loss that went into a person he could with faith say, it is well with my soul after having lost one child to disease and four daughters to the shipwreck. But in the end, he also ended up having two more daughters and a business that kept right on track. Okay, I think I got everybody on stage. Anyway, it's been an important part of this orchestra program. It's always a thrill doing it. They play it with such heart. When we've done it at contests before, even the judges have commented on, they've never heard this piece done with such heart before. Because they figured out, it's touched the heartstring of theirs, they figured out themselves what the piece was about and able to bring it alive. So tonight, with our 30 plus additional alumni, we present on a hymn song of Philip Bliss.